Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Noelle and I do unboxings, mostly lifestyle subscription boxes, but many different categories. And today is one of my favorite days because I get to share with you the next installment in Safiya's World Music Tour, which combines two of my favorite subscription categories, lifestyle and travel. So every month this subscription takes you to a different destination, not only through different items from that destination and some really cool travel gadgets sometimes, but also through the art of music. So there are three different subscription tiers to fit any budget. There is the general admission ticket, which is mostly just the music downloads, as well as some paper goods, some guides and postcards, what have you. And then there's also the book bag, which is $59.99. Now that includes a whole bunch of fun items from the destination or made by artists from that destination, as well as those cool gadgets that you can use on your own travel adventures. And then finally, there is the full suitcase, which is what I am able to share with you here on the channel. That is $130, but it includes a really cool VIP experience with an artist from that destination. You get to tune in to a Zoom meeting. They do a live concert that you get to enjoy in the comfort of your own home. They do a really cool cultural experience. It could be a dance lesson. It could be a cooking lesson. It could be a little language lesson. And you get to ask questions of that artist, which I think is so cool. Now, 10% of the proceeds do go towards the artists that are working with Safiya on this box, which I think is also just a really great cause because so many of these amazing musicians have been so affected by the pandemic. We are starting to get back to some live music and I'm really looking forward to getting to some concerts very, very soon. But I just love how she has really brought the world to us, and music is such a great and important part of any culture. And I think a lot of the times we don't realize how diverse the music in a country can be. Sometimes we kind of get hung up on the stereotypical sounds, but she does such a great job of really showing us the influences that they've had on the other music that we might hear in our daily lives. Now, if you use the code Noelle, you can save 20% on your subscription, but let's go ahead and get into it. Now, this time I did it a little bit differently because she packs these boxes so full. They're usually bursting at the seams, and that was the case this time as well. And I usually feel like I'm just kind of running through it super duper fast. So she actually sent me two boxes this time. Now, one of the reasons she sent me this smaller box is just so that I have it to take some nice photos for over on Instagram, but she was also kind enough to send some items for my husband as well, because this is definitely a subscription. It's not just for the ladies. I think that the men can definitely appreciate it as well, and she keeps that in mind. So some of the kind of souvenir items, some of the cultural items, she definitely does get some that men can enjoy as well, so I will be showing you those as well. Now, what's really beautiful is once you open up the bubble mailer that's kind of holding that box all together, because like I said, it is always bursting at the seams, then she does such a beautiful presentation with some shred, and then there's always this little bundle that tells you about the destination. There's usually this little compass charm. There's usually a fun keychain, so you can probably guess from those Rasta colors there what our destination is. Now, this time I was actually away during the different live performances that were included with the full suitcase. I believe there were actually three different artists this time, which was a new thing for this box. Pretty cool. But she always personalizes it. You kind of got this little like luggage tag or plane ticket, and she always has a little cutout, and there is the country that we're going to, Jamaica. So I just wanted to share with you, this is always on the top, but I wanted to go ahead and pull everything out. Then we always have our playlist, which is right here on the ticket. There's a QR code. She uses QR codes for a lot of the things in the booklet, the guide that's included. And then there are a couple other things that I pulled out. For example, there is a recipe card, which I'll put here off to the side, as well as some kind of postcards. So we have the man, Bob Marley, which is probably who we all think of when we think of Jamaica and music, as well as another one that looks like a runner holding the flag. And of course, they're also known for their athletes in Jamaica. So that seems pretty, pretty poignant, pretty evocative of the country. And then we have a couple of other items. So she always does this really nice pamphlet. It really is kind of a travel guide. And again, like I said, there is always a lot of information. She does a nice table of contents. There is a nice quick note from Safiya. It says, when making this box, we got the whole family and community involvement. My stepdad is Jamaican, so I had to do this box justice. We started out with an idea, and as usual, when we started purchasing for the box, things changed really quick. The box started to change into a food box because Jamaica has a lot of flavors. Some things unfortunately weren't able to come through customs, we were sent back, so we supported local businesses in New York City again, because New York is home to the largest Jamaican immigrant community outside of Jamaica. We spoke with many businesses, but we have to give special thank you to Mr. Oswald Reed from Iberian Food Corp for his help with supporting local businesses in the New York City area. And special thanks to my two aunts, Auntie Karen, who helped procure most of the food items, and Auntie Cydia, who helped with suggestions, and for the suitcase baskets were part of the live cultural experience. So I kind of love all of the like family involvement that goes into this box as well. And you guys, Safiya has been super duper busy because she also just dropped her single, which is amazing. So if you haven't checked that out yet, definitely do. But just wanted to show you a couple more things. So here is the virtual tour. There's all the QR codes there. She talks about the things that you want to think about when you are planning your trip to Jamaica, like the best time to go, knowing about, you know, bringing your DEET, because there are some little critters that will make you a little itchy, festivals that you should check out. We've got best places to listen to live reggae in Jamaica. We have fun tourist attractions with history attached, like the QR codes. She shows us some of the fun places that you might go if you are actually visiting Jamaica, like Dunn River Falls, which I have had the pleasure of kind of crawling around, sliding around. It is beautiful, as well as the Blue Lagoon. Then we also have a little bit more on the like cultural side here. So for example, there's this little paragraph where it says, Queen Nanny, Jamaica is known for its slave revolts, and one of the most noticeable historical figures is Queen Nanny. She led a community of formerly enslaved Africans called the Windward Maroons. During the major slave uprising known as the Maroon War, Nanny led the Maroons in plantation raids to free slaves. She's the only national heroine of Jamaica. Her image is on the Jamaican $500 note, which is called a nanny in Jamaican slang. So I love all those kind of little cultural tidbits. We have some information about the music of Jamaica, some information about Rasta culture, some information about jerk, the seasoning of the nation, a little bit about some of the items that are going to be in the box, lots of edible items like she kind of spoiled there in that note. There's another recipe in here for some saltfish fritters. And then finally in the back, we hear a little bit more about the featured artist. And in this case, it is Ariana Stanberry, and she looks like an amazing artist. I've only been able to listen to a couple of songs, but I'm sure it's gonna be awesome. I love to listen to the playlist that goes along with the box when I'm taking photos of the box for over on Instagram. The other artist that's featured in here is a conscious reggae band. So very, very cool. And then there's even a word search. So this is definitely a box that you can enjoy with your family. Now, the other thing that she does include is this little passport, which does have most of the items actually listed. And she does kind of divide it from destination items as well as travel items. So I've kind of tried to do that myself here. I even kind of pulled out a lot of the food items. And then she just does such a great job. I think she has so much fun procuring the items that there's always so many extras that don't actually make it on that list. So I just want to make sure that I get through as many of them as possible. So we're gonna go ahead and start with our destination items. I think I've kind of gotten everything in order, but we'll have to see. So first there is this really cool Ja Rastafari mug with spoon, and I wanna go ahead and pull this out. So of course we have the colors of red, yellow, and green. There is a lot of reggae influence in Hawaii, which is where I grew up, so I've heard a lot of reggae. We had a lot of Bob Marley at all of our dances. We had Ziggy Marley at my prom. So here you can see they have the classic symbol there, the lion. And then of course there's even a spoon, so I feel like this is, could be good for your hot cocos or whatever you have to mix things up in. Now there is also this fun kind of a little bit touristy magnet that says Jamaica. Now I know some people who like to collect their magnets when they actually travel, so I don't usually like to get souvenirs that say the destination if I haven't actually been to the place, but I have had the opportunity to visit Jamaica twice, so this is a very cute magnet. I will try to take some photos for you guys over on Instagram. Now we also have some other items. I'm gonna go ahead and open up the bigger box so that you can kind of see. And even this is full, and I only have half the contents in here because I pulled half of them out. So we have a Bob Marley bag, and this is the kind of cinch bag that you can kind of use as a nice like drawstring backpack. So we have that. And then we also have the classic Rasta hat, so you can keep all of your dreadlocks all nice and neat. Now I probably won't wear this, but you could kind of wear it as a like cute little beanie or something, you know. Then we also have a lot of Rasta jewelry, and this is not the only jewelry that's in the box, but this is the ones that I pulled out that had those classic colors. So we have got some bracelets here with a little organic something there, symbol there on the bracelet, as well as this one, this necklace with some beads as well as shells, which I think gives it that nice Caribbean flavor, of course. Then we also have to move along to our food. Now, I went ahead and kind of pulled all of the food items out and put them aside into a little basket so that I could pull everything out to show you, hopefully in pretty quick fashion. Now, one of the most important parts is listed in that booklet, and that is some jerk seasoning. And of course, everybody has their own opinions in Jamaica about where you get the best jerk chicken. I went to a couple of the places, and I have to say, I do really enjoy that bit of spice. It is delicious. Then we also got some ginger candy, which came in the cutest little box. And I love ginger candy. I love ginger anything, just because, of course, it's also really good and settling for the stomach. But we just got a couple of them right in here, just these little ginger candies, which I'm sure are going to be awesome. Now, you guys, we got a bunch of edible treats. We got so many different cakes. So we got a rum fruit cake. Look how big these are. They're like giant muffins. Then we also got our round bun. So this is one. They're all like listed very nicely. I don't know how I'm going to photograph all of these. We also got a sugar bun. So we got three pretty hefty like bread treats. Then we got a fruit bag for the market. Now these are very popular in all kinds of subscription boxes, but I definitely don't have one that is quite this neon green yet. Now, before we go back to the food, there are a bunch of bags and I didn't see them all listed on here. She also included this really cute like lace bag that does have an interior liner so that, you know, everybody can't see all of your lace, but it's just got these faux leather straps and I thought it was pretty cute. But this was definitely also included, so kind of a travel item that you could use in your daily trips to the store or just out and about when you are in Jamaica. It's kind of nice that it is also pretty neutral. And then finally, we also got this really blingy wet dry bag, which are so great, especially if you are going to Duns River Falls, right? And you might have to change your clothes and put your wet swimsuit in something else. So it's a wet dry bag, but it's with that really fun, those sequins where you can kind of move them in each direction. And I think she left me a little note that kind of says hi right here. So pretty cute. And I love that it's sequins. I think that's fun. Very, very mermaidy. And again, very great for vacation. I just didn't make it, I don't think, on the travel item list. Now we can go back to our food items. We also got a seasoned mix for saltfish fritters, which we do have a recipe for in there, as well as, let's see, I think there's a few more things, you guys. We got the Mountain Peak instant coffee, which I think is known as some of the best instant coffee around because Jamaica is also known for their coffee. And then finally, we got some banana plantain chips, and I love my salty and crunchy and savory snacks, so I'm pretty excited about that. There was, I believe, one other food item that I didn't see listed. Oh, so this is the fruit rum cake. So I did mention that, but we also got those three different buns. So one of them, I guess, was maybe something else. We got the round bun, we got the sugar bun, and then we got the fruit cake, right? So that wasn't necessarily on there. So we got all kinds of baked goods, which I'm pretty excited about. Now we also got this beautiful Jamaica journal, and she has kind of included travel journals in all of the boxes so far. This one is actually made out of leather, and I think you can actually see the embossed, the nice compass there on the front, and then it does actually have the flag of Jamaica along here on the bottom, as well as the word Jamaica. It's got this cool like anchor hanging off the side, as well as this ship's wheel here that ties everything closed. And I just thought this was pretty fancy. It feels like from like a pirate ship or something. So I don't know what I'm going to do with all of these travel journals, because I usually just have my travel journal be photos, but it is kind of nice because it's got this kind of binding so you can take the pages in and out. And of course, you don't have to just use the journal just for the destination of Jamaica. So that was what we had for the most part. Now we also have so many other items, you guys. I'm gonna have to do my best to get through it. So we have a bunch of jewelry. and I will just show them as quickly as I possibly can. Now, I love these tassel earrings. These are gorgeous. We got two pairs of those. Then there's also these really fun black tassel earrings, which I think will look very elegant. And then on top of that, I got some more bracelets, like corded jewelry. That's not usually my type of jewelry, but I can definitely pass them on to someone. We have this cross and little musical notes, which is kind of cool, like a clef, so you could give that to someone who really loves their music. And then we also have some fun brightly colored earrings that I think would be fun for any tropical destination. And then finally, this last little item that also came in a little bag with some kind of almost like moonstones, which I think is really, really pretty and delicate. I tend to like the more delicate pieces. And I really feel like this box has so much in it, but I feel like I would prefer to have fewer items of higher quality or higher value than so many like trinket items. But this is also a great box where you can definitely share. And then finally, there's this beautiful blue set of earrings and necklace. We also got this gorgeous tie-dyed wrap. I have a feeling that there are some variations going on in the different boxes. And then in terms of our travel items, you guys, we got a ton. And again, this is one of those situations where I feel like she could just put one in every box and that would be plenty. We got something that is not on the list, but is so great for all of those waterfalls that you visit in Jamaica. It's an iPhone case or a cell phone case. You can still use the touch screen, but take all of your photos and make sure you're not ruining your phone. We got this awesome mist sprayer. It does get a little bit hot and toasty there, and these are very popular right now. It gives you this nice fine mist that really just kind of refreshes you. Finally, we got a selfie ring light, which is another attachment for your phone, so you can take those gorgeous selfies of yourself, even if you just got out of the water. And we even got a universal clip lens, which is kind of another phone attachment, which is neat because they've got ones for a fisheye effect, a macro effect, and a wide angle effect. So you can actually take those panoramic shots, which is something you're gonna wanna do when you're in Jamaica or any of those Caribbean countries. So you don't have to have a super fancy SLR camera. You can do all kinds of fun tricks using those different lenses. And then I just wanted to show you some of the other items that would be included possibly if you were one of the male subscribers. And again, she was kind enough to send this so that my hubby could enjoy. So we got an extra Bob Marley bag. This one is in black, so you know, a little bit more chic, a little more masculine. We also got this really cool tropical hat, which I think is really fun and I might actually wear. I just have to kind of fix the brim there. And then some more Rasta jewelry, but this one without pendants, so it'd be a little bit more masculine once again. And then I even got a little bit more with the Jamaican flag in terms of that corded jewelry and bracelets. Now, finally, if you are doing the full suitcase, it is because it actually comes with this adorable suitcase that has all of the information from the featured artist, or in this case, artists. And there's usually a beautiful little note that is inside, which I think is awesome, usually from the artist. Then, of course, we have the little QR codes that tell you about those. And this time it's double-sided. So on one side, it is Ariana's music. And on the other side, it is Conscious Reggae Band. And then we have this really cool USB. It looks like a cassette, but of course it is not. But it actually has this little pull-out. So you can actually put that right into whatever device you use so that you can listen to the playlist, listen to the music. And then we've got this lovely little note from Ariana. And then finally, we even have something, a little post-it for today's playlist, so you can actually write down the songs that you really like, for example. And then I just think that these little suitcases are so adorable for display. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with all of the ones that I have, but I have been collecting all of my little cassettes and everything from the different boxes. But you all let me know what you think. Like I said, I think she does such a great job of curating these boxes. She really puts her whole heart into it. The whole family gets involved, and I just think that the artists that she has shared with us have been so amazing and so invested in sharing their culture, their countries with everyone. It's so much fun. And like I said, something you can definitely share with the family. I think there's so much. The value is definitely there. I feel like she could do a little bit less. I would be fine with just a couple of beautiful items from that destination, a couple of treats, some beautiful recipes, just so that I don't feel like I necessarily have such an abundance of everything. But you guys let me know. I'm sure that she will be reading the comments. She's really great about getting in there and responding to you guys. I think some of the jewelry pieces are beautiful, but I feel like just a couple of those tassel earring pairs would have been perfect for me. I didn't necessarily need all of the reggae jewelry, all of the Rasta jewelry, but I'm kind of liking this hat. I don't know if I'm going to share it with my husband or not. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up, and hopefully I see you all very, very soon in my next unboxing.